Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be explaining you later band designations and radar applications. In later band designations, one should know how bands are associated with range of frequencies. In interviews as well as in some competitive examination, I have seen one mark question that is coming frequently based on later band designation. As well as being a communication engineer, one should be having idea about which frequency belongs to which band. So here I'll be discussing about different bands with range of frequencies. So first of all, one should know what is the basic equation of frequency with respect to wavelength. Frequency is C by lambda, where C is velocity of light, that is 3×10⁸ meter per second. And based on frequency, one can easily calculate lambda. Here I'll be discussing about different bands with respect to range of frequency and range of wavelength. See here, first band, that is HF band, that is high frequency band, that is having range of frequency from 3 to 30 megahertz. And based on this frequency range, one can calculate wavelength range. Usually we talk in terms of frequency only. So it is very essential you should remember range of frequency for given bands. Second band is VHF, that is very high frequency band, that is having frequency range from 30 to 300 megahertz. Next band is UHF band, in which frequency range is from 300 megahertz to 1 gigahertz. And then next band is L band. With L band, we have 1 to 2 gigahertz of frequency. With S band, we have 2 to 4 gigahertz of frequency. With C band, we have 4 to 8 gigahertz of frequency. With X band, we have 8 to 12 gigahertz of frequency. We have KU band, which is having frequency range from 12 to 18 gigahertz. After that, we have K band, that is having frequency from 18 to 27 gigahertz. After that, we have KA band, that is having frequency from 27 to 40 gigahertz. Then after, we have V band, which is having frequency from 40 to 75 gigahertz. After that, we have W band, that is having frequency from 75 gigahertz to 110 gigahertz. After that, we have millimeter band, mm band, that is having frequency from 110 to 170 gigahertz. And with this frequency, you can observe wavelength is there in terms of millimeter. So here, see, these are the bands with which frequency range is given over here. And this is what you have to remember. I have seen in interviews, sometimes questions are coming like 7 gigahertz, that belongs to which band? At that time, you should know 8 to 12, that is there with X band, 4 to 8, that is there with C band. So 7 gigahertz, that belongs to C band. In competitive examination also, I have seen some questions like they may ask you what is the band associated with 50 gigahertz of frequency. Then one should know 50 gigahertz, that belongs to V band, right? And in interview, many of the times people are discussing in terms of band. Like if somebody is saying, I am designing microstrip antenna associated with KU band, then one should know that KU band, that is there in the frequency vicinity of 12 to 18 gigahertz. So in majority of articles, they will be writing frequency in terms of band, as well as per IEEE notations, these are the band associated with range of frequency. So in interview, in competitive examination, as well as in language of communication engineering, these bands are very essential. Now I'll be discussing about applications of radar. So here, first of all, I'll be discussing about first application, that is remote sensing application. See, remote sensing application, that is associated with weather condition. And here with the use of radar, weather monitoring, weather observation, weather prediction, that can be done with the use of remote sensing applications of radar. So here, in remote sensing, there are many applications. Weather observation useful for weather prediction, even planetary observation that can be associated with remote sensing, as well as in mapping of sea ice to route shipping, we use remote sensing application. Second application is there based on ATC, air traffic control. Usually these applications are associated with airports where traffic surveillance of aeroplanes, that is been done with the use of these applications, as well as rain area mapping, that is done with the use of ATC. See, whenever planes are arriving on the airport, as well as departure of planes that is happening from the airport, right? So that is based on this radar application, where how to route, what should be the time scheduling, whether airspace is free or not, how much traffic is there on air, all those things that is controlled with the use of ATC applications of radar. So here in the rain area mapping also, we use ATC application of radar, where as if any plane is coming and in nearer by distance, if rain is mapped over here, at that time rerouting or rescheduling can be done with the use of this application, right? See, next application that is based on highway safety. Usually in USA, this application is very popular, where with the use of radar, speed measurement of vehicle is being done. And as if somebody is not following the rules, in that case, directly from their bank account, that amount is getting deducted based on the rules, right? So here, speed measurement of vehicle that can be done with the use of radar, as well as detection of intruders that can be done with the use of radar. So on highway, usually there should not be any intruder in between, right? Highway should be straightforward, in which vehicles are going as per the lane which is mapped with respect to entry points. But if some intruders are entering in highway, in that case also that can be detected over here. See, next application that is based on aircraft safety and navigation ship safety. See, in aircraft safety and in navigation ship safety, collision avoidance that can be done with the use of radar, and usually in poor weather condition, visibility will be very poor. At that time, we use radars to have aircraft safety as well as in navigation ship safety. In harbor surveillance also, we have these applications. Now, let us talk about few more applications. Next application is there based on space, where we can use radar for landing on other planets. Like on moon, we have landed our ISRO's vehicle, where with the use of radar, we can identify surface. Is it flat surface? Is it feasible to have a landing on that surface? All those things that can be detected with the use of radar, as well as in tracking of satellite, as well as some other objects, we can use radar in space. Next applications that is based on military applications. See, in military, there are so many applications like enemy detection and enemy targeting. In enemy detection, there can be different types of enemies. Like enemies can be having aircraft, tank, drone, as well as missiles. So for a detection of these objects, we use radar in military applications, as well as for targeting enemy also, we use radar system. Now, next application that is based on geology. See, in geology, we are dealing with to identify natural resources, right? So here we are using penetrating radars. With the use of ground penetrating radar, one can have identification of natural resources like oil, gas, and minerals. So there are so many other applications even. I have listed few only. Based on these applications, I think it is quite motivating to have a learning of radar. Here with this video lecture series, you will be learning all the basic fundamentals of radar system. I hope you are enjoying this session. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.